Hi everyone, and thank you for joining us today. It's been a really crazy couple of months, but everyone's managed to pull together and some amazing pieces of work have come through this pandemic that we're all experiencing.
Everybody was invited to take major help.
Who would have thought that this is what 2020 had in store for us? However, I feel so lucky to be a part of UCW. Ross and Rich have been so supportive and committed to ensuring learning from home is possible for all of us, as well as making sure we all achieved our potential and achieved the best grades possible. So, here is a selection of films from FDA Film and Media Arts Production and BA Honours Lens-Based Media. Enjoy.
Angry. I know I should tell her. I know that I should, but it's weird to me. It's weird that love songs have been ruined for me, that the colour yellow is just her, that the ocean can never amount to her eyes, yet I stare into it daily trying to find the blue that I miss, or that I miss her. I'm scared because it's crazy to me. It's crazy that I miss her even though I see her weekly and message her every day. Crazy that I have butterflies every time I hear her name. Crazy how when she touches me, my heart rate slows down to its resting rate, but seeing her from afar almost gives me a heart attack. Crazy how I didn't mean to fall, but I'm falling hard and fast. You know what though? She deserves someone like me to love her. And I deserve to love someone like her. Not because I deserve the pain of a one-sided love, but because I deserve to feel the sunlight she gives off. I deserve to be able to look into those eyes and fall in love again and again with every blink. And before she... And she deserves to be loved. Every second of every day. Good days and bad days, and I'll be there to do so, whether she knows it or not. For someone to smile uncontrollably at their phone because she messaged them saying, hey, that's what she deserves. That's what I deserve. I deserve to feel pure joy looking at my phone just because she messaged me first. Because she thought about me. But it's funny. It's funny because for someone so smart, she has no idea how I feel about her. Sometimes I think she knows, but she can never truly know if I never tell her. I wish I could. Tell her, I mean. You see, a girl like that, she needs to know she's not alone and that she's loved. She forgets, I think. I'm here, I have her back. But then again, sometimes I don't think I show it enough. I'm sorry. But to love her feels impossible sometimes. Yet even in the moments I think I should walk away, I can't. She consumes me. All of me is hers and she doesn't know. Yet she still knows more about me than most. She can tell what's going on just by looking at me. Sometimes I wish she didn't know most things. Other times I wish she knew. I wasn't just looking at her with friendship. I was looking at her with love too. But it's hard to see the love in my eyes, and she isn't looking at me. I found out recently we do the same thing when we keep secrets from each other. She hides her face from me and pulls away. She giggles and smiles. I do too. And then I think, well, are we hiding the same secret from each other? Hiding our eyes because we know in that moment, if we looked at each other, it's game over. The secret will be out. But I don't think it's the same secret. I hope it is, but hope hurts me. She hurts me. But it's not her. It's the version I have of her in my head. The version that I bug and annoy, and I'm sorry I blame her for what she does to me. Because the real her loves me. Maybe not in the way I love her, but she does love me, and she makes sure I know it. Have I told you about her eyes? Her eyes are perfection. Even hidden behind her cute secret glasses, they cannot fully hide. Eyes, they say, are the window to the soul. Maybe that's why they're so pretty. Maybe her soul is just shining, and it happens to be blue. I wonder if she ever thinks about my eyes, my soul, the smile I make when I'm caught doing something weird. Because her face crinkles up when she does something weird. She smiles wide and scrunches her nose. She giggles. It's cute. I hope she knows it's cute. I hope he tells her.
Are you going to jump or what? Because it's been like half an hour.
There's plenty jumping off points. Get your own.
No one of you like that.
Fine. You can jump next to me.
Thank you. So why are you jumping?
Well, because I don't want to live anymore. And then again, I don't want to die. So, you?
Well, fucked my dog, and then my mum walked in. You don't seem too bothered by that though, so...
jumpers can be judges.
True.
So, why did you try to fuck your dog?
Well, I was just horny. Well, I was just masturbating and then, let's see, the dog walked in and, well, the rest is history.
If you don't mind me asking, how old is the dog?
4?
So in a dog years, she's what? 7 times 4? 28?
Yeah.
At least you're not a dog pedophile. Do you want to be friends?
Sure, I guess I should have one friend before I die.
You don't have any friends?
No. Who wants to be friends with a dog fucker? I'm 18 years old. I've never done anything with my life. I've never gone anywhere. I'm just gonna be the guy who tried to fuck his dog and then killed himself.
Why don't you go abroad now? Go on a holiday or something. Cheer yourself up.
No money. I'm broke.
You're 18, right?
Yeah.
You're definitely gonna kill yourself.
Yep.
I've got me an idea. We go to France, Lille, get a credit card, max it out, and then, after having a full lift, go and kill ourselves. How's that?
Yeah.
Wunderbar.
Des yeux qui font baisser les miens, un rire qui se perd sur sa bouche, voilà le portrait sans retouche de l'homme auquel j'appartiens. Quand il me prend dans ses bras, il me parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Il me dit des mots d'amour, des mots tous les jours, ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur une part de bonheur dont je connais la cause. C'est lui pour moi, moi pour lui dans la vie. Il me l'a dit, l'a juré. Des nuits d'amour à plus finir, un grand bonheur qui prend sa place, des ennuis, des chagrins s'effacent, heureux, heureux, en mourir.
You're done first. All right. Adios, amigo. See you in another sight.
Are you gonna jump or what? It's been like half an hour.
Why don't you sit next to me?
Okay.
So, why are you jumping?
I love you.
À toi que quand le jour sombre, que
God is king, we the soldiers. Ultra beam out the solar. When I get to heaven's gates, I ain't gotta peek over. Keeping perfect composure. When I scream at the chauffeur, I ain't mean, I'm just focused. I ain't mean, I'm just focused. Put a lean out slower. Got us clean out of soda. Before the flood, people judge. They did the same thing to Noah. Everybody wanted Yandy. That Jesus Christ did the laundry. They say that we start on Monday, but the strong start on Sunday. Won't be in bondage to any man. John 8:33. We the descendants of Abraham. Yea, should be made free. John 8:36. To whom the Son set free. He say the rich like me.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
I see Martin Thomas begging for a difference to be made. I see Marlon Thomas begging for a difference to be made. I see the Minister Louis Farrakhan saying this is Spain, this is Spain. I see Nelson Mandela saying this world is your business. I see Paul Stevens, the guy begging, saying what is doesn't have to be how it is. I see Diamond Reynolds saying there's more he wanted to achieve. And I see Eric Garner and George Floyd on the ground saying I can't breathe.
I see you've come back for more, Mr. Cuddles. I destroyed you once before and I'll destroy you again.
I don't think so, Leo. I'll destroy you before you can.
You'll never get your hands on this coin.
Oh, yes, I will.
Oh, no, you won't. Oh, no, my arm fell off.
Ha!
No!
Yoda, use your magic.
No, not the coin! No!
I told you I would. Now ready for liftoff?
No, that's not fair.
Good job, Yoda.
That's not fair. That was 2-1. That's not fair. You cheated.
Oh, no, I didn't. This is mine now.
$3.1 million people have experienced sexual abuse before the age of 16 years old. Every brown jacket I see, I start to panic. My eyes begin to water, my body starts to shake. Trauma that is so fatal, yet something so relatable. That memory will never be forgotten, which I wish was just a nightmare. My nights of dancing till early mornings is over, because it will linger everywhere I go. That anxiety when I cross the road, some people thought it was just for show. But even somewhere I thought I trusted, somewhere I called home, but really it was just a room filled with trauma and flashbacks. Now where is home? Every white shirt I see I need to burn, but nothing will make people learn. When no isn't an answer, when my worth no longer matters. Eleven people in the UK an hour are being sexually abused or raped. That anxiety that something is going to be said about that skirt you're wearing and what lipstick you put on. Red is asking for it. Pink is asking for it. Nude is asking for it. Red was Lady Birds and fire trucks. Pink was bows and candy floss. Nude was being confident with owning my own body. I've never wanted to squeeze my knees together so tight, but just trying to forget that night. One in six men have been sexually abused or raped. Every local indie skater boy are now predators. The sight of a black rolled up beanie makes me feel like my heart is pumping out my chest. Sometimes it feels like it stops when I hear their music. The smell of that cologne is smothering. The fishnet tights are wrapped around my neck, choking me, preventing me from telling people that I love, that I can't keep it in anymore. It's suffocating. Even this trauma can't be healed by meditating. Why can't we be like the Gulabi gang, not just giving a bunch of websites on a helpline leaflet? One in five women have been sexually abused or raped.
trees. Ouch. All of the park things are behind you. Where you hit them.
The hand movements that everybody put me on.
Are you having a dance battle?
Don't give us that kind of cue.
Why don't you do that, Justin? Come on, stop, Kara. Kara, stop!
Video log 58. The date is the 15th of June 2025. Subject: the day the world ended. This video is intended to serve as an archive or a time capsule to anybody or anything that finds it, in hopes that they may discover what happened to our planet, Earth. I'm not sure how many people are still alive. My current estimate is around a couple million. 1 year ago, the world as we knew it was normal. Businesses were thriving and people were going about their daily lives. It wasn't until one paralyzing day that this all began to change. On August 6th, 2024, the world experienced a phenomenon like no other. At approximately 2200 hours Greenwich Mean Time, a large area of the western and eastern hemispheres was cast in a flash of bright light, estimated to have lasted a total of 2 minutes and 13 seconds. Everyone was confused. Most were terrified. Nobody knew what to make of it. The world entered a state of panic, and the leading figures of the world set out to find answers. Months of testing and analysing samples of Earth and flora, and still the world was at an impasse. The United Nations and NASA issued a statement listing the event as an unanticipated solar flare of tremendous size, and that its effect on the planet was infinitesimal. Most people took this as gospel and continued to go about their daily lives worry-free, though some were still skeptical as to the true cause of the intense light. It was undeniable that the light came from outside our atmosphere, though where exactly it came from, not even the most prestigious of astronomers were able to answer. The world was tense. Beliefs were torn between the skeptics and those that trusted the government's word. Soon enough, everyone would see through the same eyes. The World Health Organization issued a statement revealing that there was a concerning increase in deaths due to asphyxiation worldwide, with no apparent cause. Yet again, the world didn't know what was happening. Not a single doctor knew what the catalyst for these deaths could be. Over the next few weeks, the numbers only started rising. The World Health Organization speculated that the cause was an airborne virus, though they were yet to identify any trace of disease in the postmortems of the recently deceased. In addition, the human race wasn't the only victim. It seemed that all species of wildlife and livestock were affected in similar ways. This halted agriculture worldwide. There was nothing to farm and no one to do it. To stop the spread of the supposed disease, everybody was advised to take major health precautions and remain indoors. So as the following weeks showed, this proved ineffective and the rate of deaths continued to climb. The following months saw the most devastating decline in the human population since the Black Death. The number of deaths surpassed 100 million, and by the month of February, there were 1 billion recorded cases of deaths due to asphyxia. People had no choice but to bury their dead in their gardens and mass burial grounds. The sight of it was crushing. After a majority of supermarkets and shops closed globally and indefinitely, starvation became as big of a contributor to the death count as the quote-unquote virus. In the months after this, no one needed to see the numbers, but the results were in front of us. Families were losing loved ones before their own eyes. People began starving and stopped communicating with others. Not only was there an extreme lack of staff maintaining telephone and internet communication lines, there were simply less people on the other side. In a time where everyone wanted nothing more than to be together, the world couldn't have been more distant from one another. But eventually, NASA and the nations of the world formed the consensus that the bright light that hit the Earth and the disease were linked, and assumed that this was the work of extraterrestrial life. As profound as this conclusion was, the world accepted its fate. NASA sought to send messages to the stars, pockets of information detailing the history of Earth and the human race, in case that something, somewhere, would hear our tale. Camps were set up around the world to support those deprived of nourishment and proper healthcare in what was sure to be Earth's final months, if that. That's where I am now, a camp in the southwest of the United Kingdom. Tomorrow, the stewards will be collecting items from everybody to be sent out to space or buried underground in time capsules. One of those places should be where this video log is found. I hope that somehow, by a miracle, this torment will end and that the few still surviving will rekindle the Earth with civilization.
Sunrise, warm liquor and dollars. football's kind of been part of my life since I was like six. Going to my first match with my dad, with my little sister, my mum also being Bristol City fans and going with us over the years, and my uncles as well, going to old and new Wembley, Millennium Stadium, Huddersfield, Swansea, you know, Burnley, various places around the country over the years.
Go to the pub with your friends before, you see your friends at the game, and even from a social aspect, a lot of people are sort of struggling with the sort of the hole that the football's leaving.
Over the past couple seasons, I've been going to the pub to watch quite a few just random matches with my mate, and you know, that social aspect has been like really good for me to keep, you know, social contact and all that.
I've got loads of friends who I go to watch football with, obviously at Weston, but I go and watch Norwich City play a lot as well. And to not have that interaction, it just feels very, very weird.
Football for everyone, and I'm no different, is a form of escapism.
Like, football is a distraction for a lot of people, and like, I find myself included in that, really.
There's much more important things than sport, but at the same time, sport is a way of escaping from things as well.
Every sort of Saturday or Sunday for that 90 minutes, nothing matters.
It's a lot of people's way to escape from the real world. The weekend, Tuesday night, whatever it is, it's their time to sit and watch a football away from work, away from thinking about other things, just being able to focus on that game that we all love so much.
It's a distraction from sort of everyday life, and obviously a lot of people are struggling to sort of fill that gap.
You see people on their videos together with sharing stuff like the toilet roll and stay home games.
You see a lot of people doing skills and challenges on social media, just trying to keep football alive.
The thing is, it's not just the sport, it's people's livelihoods. People think of just the Premier League and maybe the Championship kind of thing, you know, and the European games. But what about the people in League One, League Two, National League, all the people that work at the stadiums, all the people that work in the social media of it, you know, people who, their livelihoods, their mortgages.
I'm the marketing manager at Weston Football Club, so I spend the majority of my day thinking about how I can improve the club, how we can do things better from a marketing point of view, about the rest of the club as well. It's all I ever really think about. So obviously now there's no football, there's not particularly much to market, there's no more moving parts, and that's very strange.
This period without football is odd. It makes you realise how you've taken it for granted.
It's weird, it really is a surreal feeling without sport, and it makes you realise and appreciate something that you probably take it for granted on a daily basis.
But now, there is nothing, nothing at all, and is it going to come back? At what point did we think, especially during this season, that we'd miss the hoo-ha about an offside, or, you know, a red card or something like that? You know, you're just screaming out for that at this moment in time more than you'd ever truly imagine was possible.
Let's hope we can get more people into the stadiums, more people into sport, and more people into the world of not just football but all sport.
Thank you.
It's hard to describe our relationship. I don't love you. I don't want you, but I need you. If the pain, exhaustion, and desperation my body feels for you would cease, then I'd stop. But I know I can't survive without you in my life. My friends, well, they'd never understand. I've tried explaining, but they just respond I'm being silly. You'll get over it, it'll phase out. And I don't expect them to, because it's complicated, right? I'm completely obsessed with you. Obsessed with not wanting you. I can't walk away from the only thing keeping me alive. They say everything in moderation, but I can't rationalize with myself to practice moderation. And when it comes to you, sometimes I just have to look at you really hard. I know you have no thoughts or opinions or feelings towards me, but if only you knew mine toward you. It's true what they say. You don't know what's happening behind closed doors. I smile and laugh, but in my mind it's a dark room and I'm scared and alone. Maybe if I love myself more, we will be okay. But I don't. Mirrors are cruel, and the more I scroll on Instagram and see these girls, thick but skinny, tall but booby, I wonder why I can't look like this. If I did, would we be okay? Could I be comfortable with you then? Would I be worthy of letting you in then? I guess who knows. I guess who knows. I'll just keep smiling and being okay, because I guess you can't break up with food.
You got a light? Cheers. God, that doesn't work, just fucking suck lately. I don't know what's going on with that manager, but she has been on me constantly. And I'm working as hard as I can, but it's just not enough. Plus, my wife got laid off, so I'm having to work overtime to pay the rent. I never see her anymore. This is so much. Plus, you know, there's the fact that the planet's fucking dying, and I'm just sat here smoking a fucking cigarette.
You sure about that?
Yes, I'm sure the planet's dying. Just sucks, doesn't it? Life. Well, cheers, actually, that one was nearly empty.
In the ninth inning, when the preacher came in with runners on first and second and one out, Mantle swung around on him. And though the catcher didn't step wide of the plate, yet Rowe didn't give him anything good to hit at and walked him, then got the next two men who were left-hand batters. There's a liner to left center for a base hit. Here comes McDougal, rounding third, coming in to score as Snyder's throw goes into Reese.
Right, that's it.
Where are you going?
That way.
You don't even know what's that way.
Yeah, well, I'd rather be somewhere I don't know than stuck here with someone I don't like.
You forgot something. What did you do that for?
Angry.
Oh, so we're talking about our emotions now then. Pissed. Get in the car. You know, outbursts like that are the reason why I was stuck in this musty-ass car on this musty-ass road in the middle of nowhere.
What do you mean? Alright, fair enough.
You know, you get so worked up about things. I bet you can't even remember what we argued about.
Oh, I remember. It was the texts.
You shouldn't have been reading them anyway.
I was just worried and scared that I would end up having to go through losing you all over again.
Is it on? I can see a red light. Does that mean it's working? Fantastic. Hi, I'm Kenny, and I'm going to the moon.
Kenneth, did you find a job today?
Well, about that.
Kenneth, the world's not going to give you any handouts. When I was your age, I had two jobs. Do you know what they were?
But Dad, look what I found.
Stop living up there. Start living down here with the rest of us.
You do realise we have cups for the pick and mix, don't you?
Couldn't get them to work. That's when the moon's out.
Oh, hi. Are you still serving?
We're actually closing in about 5 minutes, so...
No chance of a quick cup of tea and a piece of that red velvet cake, is there?
Sure.
Okay, thanks. And could you bring it to the table as well, please?
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah.
Thank you.
Excuse me? Excuse me? Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were someone else. Dad, wake up. Get up!
No. What? Alice, what time is it?
How have you managed to do it?
To do what?
Oh, look around you, Dad. The place is a shithole. Oh,
it's not that bad, Alice. I'll sort it out in the morning.
Oh, no, you won't, Dad. This has got to stop. Where's that list I left you? Did you even look at it?
Yeah. I did, yeah. I put the bins out. I didn't do all of them.
And did you go shopping?
No, I didn't.
And Bonnie, did you walk her?
I was going to.
Oh, but... Enough. I've been at work all day. All I wanted to do was to come home and relax in a lovely, clean house. And that's not happening now, is it? Why is it always the same? You know what? I can't be dealing with this with you right now.
Where are you going?
I'm going to walk your dog because you can't seem to be bothered.
Alice, wait.
Oh, when are you going to get your life together, Dad? If Mum were here to see you like this, she'd be ashamed.
Well, she isn't here, is she? And there's not much we can do about that.
Well, I'd much rather have her here right now than you. At least she would have asked me how my day was.
Oh, I'm sorry, darling. How was your day?
As if you really cared. Bonnie? Hey, have you seen my dog? Hey, wait! I need you to go out and look for Bonnie. She ran off. Dad?
Alice? Is that you?
Hello?
Oh, I wondered when you'd get back. Your dinner's been on the table for ages. Oh my God, Alice, what happened? Your head?
Mum?
Oh, it looks really bad. Come on, let me sort it for you.
What are you doing here? How can you be here? Where's Dad?
What do you mean?
Where is he? I need him to go and look for Bonnie. He's not going to be happy that I lost her.
Who's Bonnie, love?
Our dog.
Alice, that head injury has you all confused. We don't have a dog, sweetie.
Yes, we do.
I think I need to take you to the hospital. You might have a concussion.
No, I don't have concussion. Just tell me where Dad is.
Don't you remember? He was very ill, and, well...
No. No. Dad never got sick. It was you. You were the one who got sick. How can you be here? You died.
Don't be silly, Alice. You shouldn't joke about these things. It's not funny.
No, I'm being serious.
Well, it must have been a dream or something, because I'm here. And I'm fine.
Dad? Dad?
Alice! Darling! Your dad's no longer with us. You remember that, right?
Dad! Dad, you need to wake up! He's alive. He's alive. He was right here. None of this makes sense. Supposed to be in the hospital. Hello, are you listening to me?
Alice, stop it.
Don't blame your father, sweetie. He was only doing what I asked him to do. I wanted to spend some time at home with you, Alice. You haven't visited for days.
I don't care. You need to go back. It's the only place you're going to get better.
There's not much else they can do, love.
So you're going to give up? You can't. It's not fair.
Alice.
Dad, tell her. Please. Tell her she needs to go back. Tell her it's the only way she's going to get
Alice,
better.
Alice, stop it.
I'm sorry, Alice.
No, you're not trying hard enough.
Alice, that's enough. Can't you see your mother just wants to spend some more time with you? And all this pointless bickering, it's not helping. No, I think you should apologize
to me. Why should I? You want her to get better just as much as I do.
Why do you have to be so inconsiderate? Why can't you just do what your mother asks for once?
You need to be in the hospital. I don't want to see you again until you are.
Alice, don't go, please.
I'm sorry, love. I don't know what's got into her.
She's just upset. She'll come round.
I hope so. I'll make some tea. You take it easy, all right?
Dad, wait.
It's wonderful, isn't it?
What?
A painting.
I don't understand. How is this here? Why is it here?
Because you painted it, silly. It's one of my favourites.
I know. But it shouldn't be here. I destroyed it.
You destroyed it? Alice, why? It was such a lovely painting.
Because I was angry with you. Inconsiderate and selfish and stubborn. I was so caught up in my own feelings that I lost track of how I was hurting you.
Alice, you didn't hurt me.
Oh, I did, Mum. You were so ill and I was so awful. I wish I could go back and change my last moments with you. I would give anything to have that time back.
One of the most important things you'll learn when you grow up is that you can't always change the way things are. You can't predict the future, and we shouldn't dwell on the past. The best thing you can do is keep going. Keep moving forward, and that's what you need to do, sweetheart.
But I don't want to move forward. I want to go back and go back to how things used to be when we were all together and happy before any of this happened. You should see what it's like. Dad can't tie his own shoelaces without you. He isn't dead, is he?
No, love. He's fine. But he needs you more than you know it. He needs all the help he can get. And I think you need him too.
I know. I realise that now. But I don't want to go back. Not yet. Not without you.
No, I'll always be here. Always. But your father is the one who needs you right now. You need to help each other.
But...
No buts. And trust me.
Goodbye, Mum.
Goodbye, sweetheart.
Alice! Can you hear me? Alice! Sweetheart, please wake up! Oh, thank God! Oh, had to be worried sick. You all right?
I'm fine. Where's Bonnie?
Oh, she's around here somewhere. She led me to you.
Oh, that dog's not as stupid as I thought she was. I saw Mum, and it was real, very real. At least it felt real, I thought it was.
Alice.
But then she told me that you had died, and I knew that couldn't be right because I remember you here with Bonnie, and it upset me. You should have seen her, Dad. She was so healthy and beautiful. I don't know why she married you.
Little bugger. How was she?
She was just as I remembered her. Oh, and a lot tidier than you.
Well.
You don't need to explain, Dad. I know you're trying.
Maybe I could try a bit harder.
Dad. Do you still have any of Mum's paintings?
No, I think there's some up in the attic. Why'd you ask?
It'd be good to get them down.
Yeah, I'm fine. It's just a bloody oven.
Well, you're just cooking things for too long?
Mm.
Yeah, I'm not eating that.
Neither am I. Takeaway?
Only if you're paying. Right. I'm gonna have a shower.
All right, don't be too long. Oh, I found it, by the way. It's up in your bedroom.